The self-balancing robot kit is a complete and easy-to-build kit for a self-balancing robot. It features two individually motorized wheels, a lipo battery, an ESP32S3-based controller board with a USB-C and a microSD card socket with a 32GB microSD card, an ultrasonic transducer, a 240 by 320 pixel color TFT display, and of course an accelerometer. A battery charger is included too. The software is Arduino-based and fully open source. Because its brain is an ESP32S3 microcontroller, the robot can be controlled remotely over Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, or ESP-NOW. The self-balancing robot kit contains all the parts required, and even a screwdriver. However, you will need pliers to fix the nuts and bolts properly. Assembling the robot starts with the motor frame. First, attach the two motor supports to the base plate. Mount them inside the wide rectangles on the bottom side. Use locking washers to block the nuts. Attach the motors to their supports with 6 screws. The motor axles should be as far away from the base plate as possible to allow for space under the motors. It is also possible to mount them the other way around if you want to lower the center of gravity of the robot. However, if you do this, left and right will be swapped. Fix the wheel holders to the motor axles. Slide them on as far as possible. Align the flat side of the axle with one of the hex screws of the wheel holder. Tighten well. Attach the wheels with a screw to the holder. Connect the motor cables to the motors. It doesn't matter which cable goes on which motor. Stick the other end through the slotted holes on the same side of the base plate. Check the orientation of the connectors. The two keys or little tabs should be on the outside. Insert the two tie wraps to fix the battery. Be careful when inserting the battery. Its connector should point to the motor connectors. The battery cable must not be fixed with the tie wraps. The longest motor cable can be fixed using the tie wraps. The next step is to mount the 4 middle-sized standoffs for the controller board onto the base plate. Use locking washers to block the screws. Now we'll mount the controller board on the standoffs. Make sure the motor and battery sockets on the board are on the same side as the connectors. First, connect the motor cables to the board. Then connect the battery cable. Finally, mount the board on the standoffs with 4 screws. Next is the display assembly. Remove the protective film from both sides of the acrylic plate. Fix the 4 short standoffs to the center of the plate. Attach the display to the standoffs with 4 screws and locking washers. Connect the display cable to the socket. Either way is possible. Mount the 4 long standoffs for the controller board. Use locking washers to block the screws. Connect the ultrasonic transducer to its socket. Connect the display cable to the controller board. Attach the acrylic plate to the long standoffs with 4 screws and locking washers. Finally, slide the protective rubber strip on the front and rear side of the controller board. Your robot is now ready for programming. But first we will charge its battery with the supplied charger. When the LED turns green, the battery is fully charged. We will use the Arduino IDE to program the self-balancing robot. I use version 1.8.19. Using the Boards Manager, you must install the ESP32 Arduino core. I use version 2.0.17 because version 3 and higher is not compatible with the double Bluetooth controller library used for the robot. Download the self-balancing robot software from the Elektor Labs website and unpack it into your sketchbook folder. Most libraries are included, except for the graphics library for Arduino by Moon on Our Nation. Install version 1.4.6 using the Arduino IDE's library manager. A detailed software installation guide is available from the Elektor Labs page for the self-balancing robot. The download also contains a folder named SD card. Copy the files contained in this folder to the microSD card and stick the card back into the robot. Before we can program the robot, we must execute two calibration steps. To make calibration easy, but also for future work on the robot, it is practical to build a jig to hold the robot so that its wheels don't touch the ground. I made one out of a wooden wine bottle box. With four screws, I can adjust the horizontality of the robot. This is a practical jig, as you can also use it to store the robot in. We will now calibrate the accelerometer, or, to be more precise, the inertial measurement unit, or IMU. Upload the sketch SB robot IMU 0. Open the serial monitor and set the baud rate to 115200. Reset the robot and wait for the sketch to finish. This takes a few minutes. Enter the offset values in the sketch SB robot double, somewhere starting around line 100. Your values will be different. Do not keep the default values. Next is the calibration of the motors. Upload the sketch SB robot motor compare and open the serial monitor. First, we will determine the minimum speed. Use the S, L, or R and the U or D commands to find the minimum value that keeps the motor spinning and the minimum value that makes the motor start spinning. Write these values down. Next, we will compare the motors. Close the serial monitor and open the serial plotter. Use the C command to start, then use the RL commands to slow down one of the motors. The corresponding graph in the serial plotter will move up. Adjust the motor speeds this way to make the graphs overlap each other as well as possible. Use the S command to stop. Close the serial plotter and open the serial monitor again. Use the P command to display speeds and ratios and write these values down. Enter these values in the sketch SB robot double. Your values will be different, do not keep the default values. With the adjustments made, upload the sketch SB robot double to the robot. Make sure to compile it with the ESP32 Arduino Core 2.0.17 or lower. Install Devil on a smartphone or a tablet. Use Devil in gamepad mode. Do not connect the smartphone to the SB robot Bluetooth device, let Devil do it for you. Up, down, left and right only work separately. They should not be pressed together. Carefully place it on the floor. Make sure there is enough free space. When the app is connected, the robot starts to balance. Be careful, remote control is quite complicated and it's easy to lose control. The robot may fall over and even jump around. It may be surprising, but the robot balances best on a rough surface. An uneven surface prevents the robot from gaining too much speed and get out of control. Keep in mind that the self-balancing robot kit is intended for experimenting and learning. It is up to you to make it better and use all its features. The default PID settings will probably work reasonably well, but adjusting them may improve the robot's balancing performance. The PID parameters are found at line 165. KP, where P means proportional, has the most influence. High values will make the robot too nervous. Low values will make it too slow. KI, with I meaning integral, and KD, with D for derivative, are used for fine-tuning. There you are, your robot is ready for use.